That's the original coil in there. Take the freezer thermostat, disconnect it, and take the cover out. Give us more room. This refrigerator is a 1992, and it's all original. Original compressors, original evaporator. Okay, we're going to use our charging column to recover refrigerant. We have a little over 60 pounds pressure in there. Okay, we got about a little bit over 4 ounces of gas in there. I put some Freon in here the other day when I was in here just to give them refrigeration until I got back. Okay, so now we're going to cut the evaporator out. sure you got the right one. It's not kinked. Okay. That one looks a little kinked. This is all aluminum, this evaporator. Thank you. Okay, next thing we're going to do is we're going to pressurize this with nitrogen and check our joints and make sure we don't have any leaks. And then we'll clamp this down and finish up, weigh the gas in. Pressurize the system with nitrogen. Use a high side gauge. You could wind up ruining your low side gauge. We got a leak there, see it? Okay. Okay, so we soldered that joint. Looks like we're okay. Looks good. So let's drain out the nitrogen. Up our compound gauge and start to put this back together. Should be on a 45 degree angle, like about like that. And stick it in here and pinch the tubing. Thank you.
make sure the bars are on. Alright, so this takes 7 ounces of R12.
What I'm doing here is I'm hooking up a high side gate hose. I'm going to turn on the compressor and let the compressor suck out all the air. And then we'll recharge it. Make sure this gauge is closed. Compressor's on. Pull them down. Okay. Now, put some gas in our charging column. All right, so we have 4 ounces. I'm gonna put 3 more ounces of R12 in here. Pressure is looking good. Close off the valve.